The show is about a couple in their 30s, and they have been dating for 6 or 7 years, which is a long time to date when you're in your 30s, at least according to her. And the show, the pilot, picks up when they get back from their 6th dating anniversary trip to Mexico. She had thought he was going to propose on that trip. He didn't. When they get home, he's going to go to bed. She turns away to go to the kitchen and basically explodes and screams at him all the stuff she's been thinking. How could you not have proposed on this trip or sometime during the last 6 years? What we see as the audience is that he gets down on his knee behind her and pulls out a ring and was planning to propose, but she doesn't see him and just basically goes crazy, eviscerates him, eviscerates his mom, eviscerates his friends in this big sort of screaming match of, I can't believe you haven't proposed. And then he finally gets her to turn around, and she's obviously sort of completely destroyed by that. I think her exploding and saying, how could you not have proposed, comes more from a place of vulnerability of, do you, after 6 years, if this guy hasn't proposed and we're in our 30s, am I not good enough? Do you not love me? That kind of stuff, which I think is relatable for all of us. So it doesn't come from like this anger place or this I want to be married place. It's more from why hasn't it happened? What are the reasons for that? She's right for it because she is so funny and such a great actress. And the part is inspired by her. So I think if I were to cast an actress that is one of her competitors, we would no longer be married. She is the perfect person for the part. She inspired the part. She is hilarious and real at the same time, which is very difficult to do. A lot of people who are hilarious, it plays broad. She plays very real, which I love because I do want it to feel like a real couple. It's really funny. I swear, I promise that I will make it very funny. And we have incredibly hilarious actors on it, which is the benefit because they make the script seem so much better than it is, and they add a bunch of their own funny stuff, which is great, that I still weirdly get writing credit for because I'm the creator of the pilot. So even though they add a bunch of stuff, I still get the credit, which is good for me and good for them and good for you guys because it's funny. It's just, you know, regular stories about a couple or their friends or her dads. The Annie character doesn't have a mom. She has two gay dads who had her through surrogacy. Played by Tim Meadows, who is hilarious and one of my idols my whole life, and Dan Bukatinski, who is also hilarious and I've been a gigantic fan of for a long time. Very excited about those two. And they play her dads. And yeah, so stories about them, stories about the couple, stories about friends, regular stories. It's not like each episode is, well, this is the picking the cake episode or so, you know what I mean? It's literally, it's just a couple.